What's up, guys? Welcome to another spotlight on the Friends Gathered Epic server running modded Scorched Earth. Today, we're going to focus on Stargate Atlantis mod created by Oxy. I'll make sure I leave you guys a link in the down there for the mod and for Oxy's workshop. Hey, talking about, I appreciate all the subs from you guys. If you like the spotlight, be sure to press the thumbs up button and share with your friends. And if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. You don't want to miss out on future spotlights. If you have ideas for mod spotlights and you'd like to see something on some of those, just leave a comment in the comment section. I'll read them. And if it's a mod that I can get a hold of, I'd be happy to do it. Oh, and a reminder, don't forget, we stream almost nightly on our Scorched Earth modded server, and I also have a single player that I play occasionally that has a lot of the same mods. Hello, thing. Okay, that's enough of that. Let's get on to the mod. So, we are going to focus on this baby right here, Stargate Atlantis mod. So, you're going to need one of these, this ancient workbench, to get started. So let's see, what does it take to get the ancient workbench? Okay, it can be made in your backpack. You don't need any kind of special workstation or anything to make it. So what kind of resources is it going to require? Well, BENCH. Looks like 400 metal ingots, 50 crystal, and 50 electronics. Okay, so that's a little hefty. But we should have some of that laying around. Let's see if we got it. And then, let's double check what I need to make these. I need metal ingots. Okay, let's turn it on. And we want to go ahead and make 100 of them. Let that cook. We're also going to need a bunch of ingots, which I hope we have here. Extinguish this. We do. I don't know if I have enough in there. Let's see. Bench. Typing is a skill. Alright. Okay, we got enough of that. We're going to need 50 crystal. And then we'll need those electronics when they're done cooking. Just go ahead and get some crystal. I don't know if we've got enough. Let's see. Well, guess what? We only have 87. Wait, we only need 50. Assembling station. It's like over here. Nope. How about this one? Hey, there it is. Okay. Here we go. We're looking for bench. Yep, got plenty. We just need the electronics and we're good to go. Alright, so we're going to do this. That's good. Right here. Go ahead and craft that. Alright, so that's what it takes to make. Now we're going to take this over to another base. Okay? And I built this base in my last mod spotlight. We call it the waterfall base. And what we'll do is, I'll try to do this over there so there will be less distractions. I'd love to take him over there. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get over to the other base. And I will BRBs. Alright, so we are here at the base that we created on our last spotlight. And we're just going to land up here. And we're going to find a place to put this. Alright. Take the stair down. Take us to the main workshop area of the base here. Okay. So we have lots of space. There are no issues with space here. We just have to look for an interesting place to put this workbench. And the workbench is right there. And put that over here. Now, one of the first things I've noticed about this mod is the lengthwise of the object that we're trying to place, the bench, can actually get closer to a wall than the side. So it's almost as if, I mean, if you take a look at where we are here, Okay, watch how far I have to go back to get it to place. So, right there, that's as close as we can get to a wall, right? However, if we turn it sideways, we can almost touch the wall. That's too far. There you go. See, look how close we are now. Right there. So, your placement of the item, you need to keep that in mind of where you're going to want to put it. With that being said, I think we're going to end up putting it over here. And the reason I say that is because it can almost touch the actual pillar right there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to find me a line on the floor, and I'm going to go ahead and line up this workbench to make sure that it doesn't deviate. So I got the green closest to me on that line, and it's not deviating. Okay, so that means that it's perfectly straight with the floor. Now, switch to K. That's going to lock me in place. So I'm just going to back up this way till I think I got it lined up with that pillar. And now it's placed. Here we go. Let me go ahead and dump some stuff in here. I brought some extras just in case we need it. I brought some extra supplies. All right, so one of the first things that I suggest making. Oh, wait, let's back up for a second. Let's look at the mod. What does this mod have in it? Let me find it on my list here. Stargate mod. I have a lot of mods, I know. There it is. Okay. So here is where the Stargate mod starts. It starts at the ancient workbench. We have Stargate itself. We have a 0 point module, teleporter rings, a Stargate shield. I've actually never used that because I don't play PvP very often, especially with this mod. Stargate remote, something I have no idea what it is since I'm not a level elite. And then we can talk about the lost temple rune or stone. Back up. Where'd it go? Down here. And we can talk about the ZPM jumper. The jumper ZPM. We can talk about these two later. These are kind of spoilers. And if you're looking to do some stuff in this, then I've got to do a disclaimer or whatnot before I actually dip into what those are. Okay. So the first thing we're going to make is this remote right here. And the reason we're going to do that, I will show you after we get Stargate built. But to make the remote, you can make it in our backpack or in our hand. And it takes one stone. There you go. That's it. Now I have two of them. Because I already had one in my inventory. Let's go into here. Okay, so we'll put this remote in here for right now because I've got one in my number six slot down here. Next thing we're going to make is a Stargate. Stargate requires. Let's do it this way. See, if I reduce the filter by typing something in, it moves my screen over so you can actually finish reading. It requires 200 metal ingots, 10 electronics, 100 obsidian, and 20 crystal. So we're going to go ahead and make one of these. And while that's cooking up, there's one other thing we need to do. We need to place the Stargate. Okay? Now, the trick with placing a Stargate is it's five foundations wide. Okay? And it does need to be placed on a foundation. So what I've done is I've created some foundations. There. Did I put them in my dra I put them in the workbench, didn't I? Do-do. I created some foundations, right? And we're going to put this right over here. I think I can go ahead and take this all the way out. Okay, so that's three foundations, right? Four. Five. Six. Seven. Now, I realize I told you needed five foundations, and I just created seven. However, I wanted it spaced away from the stairs. That's why we did that. Okay, so the Stargate should be ready now. Let's go ahead and grab it. Okay. We're also going to create a 0 point module. 0 point module is the power. that powers Stargate. Okay, go ahead and make one of those. While that's cooking, we're going to go ahead and place this gate, and I'll explain a couple things to you about it. All right, let's see. We'll get here, here. All right, now, you can see that it's placed, but it's facing away from me. And the reason I know that is because if you look on the left side of the ring, near the bottom, you can see there's like a little bench outline in green. If I hit E, you can see it just to the right of my screen right now, okay? But I don't have to do that. If I just back up a little bit, it should turn and change its position on its own. Well, I'm going to put it down there. That's the right spot. Okay, so now it's placed, right? And you can see that it's away from the stairs like I wanted. And we're going to have to do some other modifications and things here, but this is fine for now. This is called a DHD. If you go in here and you press E, you have this thing that lets you toggle the DHD. It's basically the dialer that lets you dial gates. And we prefer to, on our server, everybody prefers to go ahead and toggle it. You can access the Stargate and its destinations through a DHD or the remote. And we all carry remotes since they're so easy to make. Go ahead and we're going to grab this zero-point module, okay? We're going to go ahead and put it inside Stargate. So go ahead and press F. And the way it works is you drag it to the center here into the inventory, and then you put it in the trophy slot, okay? And then now it is powered. If we go over to DHD, I think it's E. If you hit E, it brings up all the addresses that you have Stargates that are connected into within your tribe. So they're all listed here. But we're going to go ahead and disable the DHD. So you can see what it looks like without it. Makes for a cleaner build. You don't have to have a bunch of extra foundations and all that cool stuff. Okay, so it's now gone. And you can see if we're looking at it, it says powered. That's because the ZPM is in it. Now, to access it, we just go to our remote, which for me is my number 6 slot. Looks like that. Right click it, and I can dial to any base. Wait for it to open. There you go. Now, if I go through there, I can go to my other base. Boom. And now we are teleported. Takes a second for everything to draw in, because you're just popping in the middle of your base, and so it has to render everything. Right? Takes a while for the graphics to catch up. As you can see, the Golem's graphics aren't quite caught up yet. And that's all going to be based on how many tiles it's got to draw in before it gets to the textures and the speed of your video card. So that's pretty much it. Now, it is going to stay open for approximately 60 seconds. If you're in a hurry, you can just walk up to it, press E, and do a forced disconnect. Takes 6 seconds to do. Not sure why it takes quite so long. And then it will go ahead and it will close the connection. Now, the reason I closed it travels only one way. If you open a portal from point A to point B, and you get to point B, you can't come back. You have to open another portal using the gate. Okay? So, I didn't name the other gate. It listed it here at the bottom as 274360. The reason I know that, because I know where all the rest of these are, and I know that this public one right here is the one I'm standing at. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and open this one. We're going to go back and name the gate. It's open. You can pop through. Probably get a... There you go. Pop down. And we're back. Okay, so now we need to name the gate. You can name the gate pretty much anything you like. We're going to go ahead and we call ours SG for Stargate. And we're going to call this Waterfall. I used to have a gate here. I took it and put it in Waterfall Base. I put it in a cave so we could get some dinos in there. So there you have it. Now, this needs to be dressed up a little bit. I'd probably put like a couple stairs here. Do I have stuff left in here? Look, I have a stair. Can I make another stair? See, ramps. I cannot, because I need stone. I've got some. So, anyway, I'm going to go ahead and just dress this up real quick. Now you can just go in and out as needed. So that's how long it lasts. I didn't make it. And I need to turn up my gamma real quick. All right, there we go. All right. So that's how we create the Stargate. It will automatically link to your other Stargates or your tribe's Stargates based on just the intelligence of the mod and how it works. You don't have to do anything to say, go find these Stargates. All right, let's talk about another item now. Teleporter rings. 20 electronics. I don't quite have enough electronics for that. You need 2 teleporter rings. So I'm going to go ahead and step away and make some teleporter rings, and then I'll BRBs, and we'll make a couple of those, and we'll show you how those work. BRBs, folks. All right, we're back, and we've got the stuff we need. So if we go in here, and we have teleporter ring, we're going to go ahead and try to make 2 of these. And let us craft 3. We'll make 2. And I'll show you how these work. Now, these have a range. And they also have a linking mechanism that's not something that would be easy if you're putting a bunch of rings to different locations next to each other. I believe it will go to the closest ring that it's placed near, unless there's been an update in the last couple days, which I guess we'll find out here in a minute when these finish crafting. We're also going to go ahead and we're going to craft a Stargate shield. Okay? Let's go ahead and do that too. And that'll cook while we're doing this. Now, teleporter rings. We have one here. So, teleporter rings are useful from getting from point A to point B. They do have a limited range, like I said. And it needs to kind of be placed out of the way, because it can do some kind of weird stuff if you're not careful, like dinos into floors or into buildings or underneath the world. Or yourself, even, if you're not careful. Okay, now we're ready to place a teleporter ring. However, you should know that last I heard, the teleporter rings were not working correctly. So I don't know what to expect when we do this. So we're going to go ahead and put down a ring here. Okay. It requires a rather large area to put it in. As you can see, it can't be too close to any structures. And then this one should also be done. We'll go ahead and grab this one. And to make this easy, we're just going to put it over here by the fireplace. All right. Now, actually, let me pick it up real quick. They're easy to pick up. I wanted to show you this. When you step on them and there's nothing for it to connect to, and nothing will happen. There's no effect. All right. Let's go ahead and put down the second one again. The second one, once you step onto it, it should now activate. Now, if it's working correctly, it'll actually teleport me from one ring to the other. Let's see if it's working or if there's still maybe a bug in the current mod. And boom. It worked. So we went from one to the other. Okay. Let's try that again. Now I should go back to the fireplace. There you go. Now I haven't tested the range on this. I can't tell you exactly how far it is. But they are cool in that way. So let me go ahead and I'm going to try to get myself to teleport upstairs. See if that will work. Or if that's something that's just not currently working. I know that Shadow, one of our friends gathered, he's a game developer. He plays with these rings a lot, and he said he'd found some issues with it. So we're going to go ahead and put it right there. Okay, we're going to step on it. See if we end up downstairs. And we didn't. Okay, so it's not letting us go downstairs for some reason. But it will allow us to stay, to go across the floor the other way. I wonder if it has something to do with it being on ceiling tile. Let me go try a floor space. I don't even know if I'll be close enough if I go out here to try this, but let's give it a shot. There we go. Okay, does it work from here? Okay, so we're outside. And now we're inside. So it's a pretty good distance. I mean, that's probably like 40 foundations away, maybe. Huh. So that's how they work. They should do elevation changes as well. I know that it's working on our other server. They were the rings that we placed were placed before one of the updates, so I know that those are working. And that's kind of how those work. All right. So we also made the shield. Well, this is a first for me. I've never had to use one of these before, but I figured if we're going to do a spotlight on it, we probably need to know how it works. So I'm going to guess put the shield here, and you put it in a costume slot. And then there might be something here. Turn shield local. Turn shield on. Okay, so we're going to turn on the shield. See what kind of effect it has. So it's got this cool shield effect. The mod author did a great job on this mod. I love this mod. Okay. Does it keep us from walking through it? Yep. It actually prevents us from walking through it. What about the other side? Absolutely. Now, what happens if we try to dial? Let's see. Is it going to blow up or something? It might be dead. That would be extremely cool if it blew up. Okay, so it's up, and... Wow. Okay, so let's see if it prevents... It didn't prevent me exiting. Let's see if it prevents me going there. And... Alright, go back to the waterfall. I might have to take a bird. This doesn't work. Or maybe I'll incinerate as I step through the gate. Wouldn't that be cool? Oh, I incinerated. That was just spectacular. That was awesome. Okay, so the shield works great. Now all we have to do is remember where our base is. Yep. And I will take this bed. And I'm going to take a bird over and get my stuff. Where's this bed at? Do I remember this bed? Oh, I know this bed. Okay. That's cool. Oxy, great job. Alright, let me go ahead and take a bird and get back to my stuff, and I'll BRBs. Alright, we're back. We're almost back to our body, I hope. Let's see if I can find my body. Oh, there I am. Ah, let's see, it didn't hurt any of my armor. And might as well take all from inventory. And looks like we got everything. Aw, poor Trace. All right, so give me a second here to get dressed again. Bam. Okay. Well, now we know exactly what the shield does. And that's a cool effect. Wow, I should like put this up in the other base and not tell people. Nah, it'll kill someone's dino. So, this ring is big enough for any dino to go through it. I haven't found, there's no dino that I have seen yet that won't fit through it. You just have to get a toe through it and it will teleport you. We will go ahead and take the shield off. So that no one dies. Okay. As a matter of fact, I'm going to pull the shield out of it so that it doesn't accidentally get activated by something or someone and kill them. That is kind of really cool. All right. Now, what does that leave us here? We've done all of those. Okay. Now we have just the jumper ZPM and the lost temple rune. Alright, this is where I gave you a disclaimer. This is a bit of a spoiler. If you want to figure out how this works on your own, then you would need to stop watching right now. And after you've explored it, maybe come back and check it out. Otherwise, you've been warned. Let's see if I have what I need to make it. I don't think I do. So that needs 3 generic artifacts, which we're not going to get. But I'm going to talk about it, okay? And then the ZPM, basically, is just 50 crystal, and it's for a specific purpose. Okay. Disclaimer's been done. You've been warned. Here goes. When you look at the rune, it gives you an address. And you use the address and put it into one of the gates. It'll take you to a secret room, a secret area that's created when you add the mod to your server. You'll take a test when you're there, okay? It's a, basically, you're looking at a pictures, and there's a right and wrong answer. I don't know what happens when you do the wrong answer, because I didn't do that, but when you do the right answer, then you unlock a jumper. What's a jumper? Okay. I can't really show it to you. There might be some information elsewhere you can look it up. Actually, it's probably in one of my streamed videos from the other server. There weren't very many of them. But basically, the jumper is like a shuttle, a mechanical spaceship kind of looking shuttle. If you know anything about Stargate, okay, the TV show, the movie, it's very similar to the jumpers that they had there. The mod author did a great job in creating it. Well, that's where you need this thing. You create the jumper ZPM to power the jumper. And the shuttle itself, okay, the jumper, it eats the ZPM at like food. Okay, the jumper ZPM and eats it like food. Now, something else you need to know. There's no way out of the secret area except a Stargate. And in my instance where we did it, the Stargate itself, right, did not have a ZPM of its own. So we actually had to use cheat codes to get out because everybody that played on the server was stuck in their room. And then there's really no way for us to get out except for, like, dying. And since we have PvP turned off, we couldn't hurt each other. And there was nothing for us to, like, jump off of to kill ourselves. So we just used some cheat codes. We got a ZPM. And we had to basically get ourselves as a ZPM to power the Stargate in order to get out of the room with our jumper. All right. So there's certain areas in this building that are not considered to be indoors, which happens sometimes. So I think we've covered everything about the mod. And we're in the middle of a sandstorm. Yay. If you have any questions, just leave them in comments. I'll see if I can answer for you. But however, I think that this mod overall is excellent. I have used it on the last four servers that I built and the last two personal instances that I've run. It's an amazing way to be able to get from one point to another and take dinos. It reduces on travel time, which for me is a big deal, especially if you're trying to do streaming or you're doing some recordings. So I just like it. I really do like it. I think Oxy has done a wonderful job with this mod. I hope you've enjoyed this spotlight. Like I said earlier, you know, if you enjoyed it, please give a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And we will be doing a new mod spotlight in the near future. Until then, later, peeps.